गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज अमला फ्रॉम डीवीएसआईटी कावली. ओके, सो नाउ इन दिस क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द लास्ट यूनिट 15 इन ईएमएल सब्जेक्ट, दैट इज नथिंग बट द टाइम वेरिंग फील्ड्स. ओके, अप टू यू कैन डिस्कस अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रिकल फोर्स एंड मैग्नेटिक फोर्स. ओके, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फोर्स. सो यू कैन डिस्कस दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फोर्स एंड मैग्नेटिक फोर्स इन स्टेशनरी फील्ड्स. ओके, सो दैट मीन्स देयर टाइम इज इंडिपेंडेंट. ओके, टाइम इनवेरिंग फील्ड्स. Okay, so but here you can discuss about the electric fields and magnetic fields is depending upon the time period. Okay, so that means time dependent. That's why this is called the time varying fields. Okay, so this time varying, so the electric fields and magnetic fields in time varying fields is discussed by using the Maxwell's equations. Okay, you can discuss about by using the Maxwell's equations. Okay, so the time varying static electric field, sorry, the time varying electric field and magnetic field will be discussed by using the Maxwell's equations. So before going to that Maxwell's equations, first you can know about the what is the statements of Faraday's law and what is the statement of Lenz's law. So I think all of you well know about this Faraday's law and Lenz's law. Okay, these are coming in mission subjects. Okay, what is the statement of Faraday's law? Whenever you can take a one closed surface, in that closed surface the electric force is produced or EMF, electromotive force. Okay, that is denoted with E. The electromotive force is proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux produced in that closed circuit or linked with that circuit. That is nothing but the statement of Faraday's law. Okay, what is the statement of Faraday's law? The electromotive force, okay, the EMF produced in a closed circuit is proportional to the rate of change of flux, okay, in that surface. That means here it is depending upon the time period. Okay, at that time E equal to minus N d phi by dt. Here N means number of turns. If suppose you can take the single turn circuit, okay, for single turn circuit N is equal to 1. At that time it will become E equal to minus d phi by dt. So here the minus sign is indicates here the electric force is produced in opposite to the direction of the magnetic flux. Okay, that's why here you can indicate the minus sign. Okay, so this is nothing but the statement of Faraday's law. Okay, next statements of Lenz's law. Okay, what is the Lenz's law? So the Lenz's law state that it opposes the cause to produce it. That means, so manaki edaithe flux produce avadaniki kaaranam avutundo dani direction ne manaki em chestundante oppose chestundi danne manam em antamante Lenz's law. Okay, what is the statement of the Lenz's law? The Lenz's law states that which opposes the cause to produce it. Okay, so that means here the cause to produce the electromotive force is nothing but the flux. Okay, it opposes the that direction. That's why here you can write the minus. Okay, so EMF. Okay, EMF is nothing but E. So E is nothing but it is a voltage. Okay, so it is produced in a what? Closed path. So here you can apply the line integral. So at that time you can write integral of E bar dot dl bar. So already you can know what is the flux. Flux phi equal flux in magnetic field. You can write in terms of magnetic flux density. Here B bar is nothing but the magnetic flux density. So at that time you can write the phi equal to integral of S B bar the ds bar. Okay. So from this, so here already you can know E equal to minus d phi by dt. So phi equal to integral of S B bar the ds. So now you can substitute this equation in this one. So at that time what happened? E equal to, so d minus d by dt, in place of phi you can substitute integral of B dot ds. So at that time E equal to, so E here E already you can write E bar dot dl bar, that is equal to, so this E is equal to minus d by dt B bar dot ds bar. So this is the equation you can obtain from the statement of both Faraday's law and Lenz's law. So from this here you can say that from this equation you can note that, so here, so the main term is B bar, okay, and E bar. So from this equation you can observe that once, so in one time B bar will be stationary, E bar will be time varying. In another time E bar will be constant and B bar will be time varying. Or either in some cases both E bar and B bar both are time varying fields. Okay, this is the statement of Faraday's law and Lenz's law in a time varying fields. Okay, from this equation you can observe that you can apply these conditions in three times. So those are, first one is E bar is potency are. These are very very important for short answers, 2 mark statements. Okay, statement of Faraday's law and statement of Lenz's law. Okay, what is the statement of Faraday's law? Okay, the Faraday's law will be states that so the EMF or the electromotive force produced in a closed loop path is proportional to the rate of change of flexure link with that circuit. That is, E is proportional to the. So first you can write E is proportional to d phi by dt. So whenever you can remove the proportional constant, you can write the one constant E equal to minus n d phi by dt. Here n is number of turns. If suppose you can take a single turn circuit, that is n is equal to 1. So at that time you can write E equal to minus d phi by dt. So what is the statement of the Lenz law? The Lenz law states that it opposes the cost to produce it. Okay. So E equal to minus n d phi by dt. So okay, from this you can write this equation. Okay, this is the statements of Faraday's law and statements of Lenz's law. Okay, this total time varying physics is explained by using the Maxwell's equations. Okay, to derive that Maxwell's equations, you are need of the Faraday's law and Lenz's law. Okay, that's why you are previously you can discuss about the Faraday's law and Lenz's law. So next you can see the one term current density. Okay, current density in time varying fields. Okay. So next, after statement of Faraday's law and statement of Lenz's law, you know that one term. Those are displacement current density and displacement current. Okay, so first of all, according to the Ampere circuit law, in stationary electromagnetic fields, you can write, okay, gradient of H bar is equal to the J bar. Okay, this is the statement already all of you know. So by taking divergence on both sides for this equation, you can apply the divergence. So divergence means, okay, gradient of H bar, gradient of J bar. Okay, so previously you can know the properties of the curl. Okay, what is the properties of the curl? So any divergence of the gradient of vector is equal to the zero. Okay, previously you can discuss, in previous class you can discuss about the properties of curl. In that you can assume one vector A bar. So in that you can take the divergence of gradient of A bar equal to zero. But in place of A bar, here you have the H bar. Here H bar, why you can take this H bar is a Mankell field intensity. Okay, so at that time divergence of gradient of H bar is equal to 0. At that time divergence of J bar is also equal to 0. So already you know in previous chapters you have the continuity equation. Equation of continuity. What is the equation of continuity? Divergence of J bar equal to minus d rho v by dt. Okay, so from this, so here there divergence of J bar equal to 0. So at that time this term is also equal to 0. Okay, so these are not practically compatible. Okay, here only our derivation purpose here you can assume. That's why here you can introduce a one constant, that is a n bar. Okay, so this is the gradient of H bar is equal to J bar plus n bar. Here n bar is a one constant, that is you can assume. Okay, so for this equation, gradient of H bar is equal to J bar plus n bar. Here you can apply it by taking the divergence on both sides. Okay, same divergence. Okay, divergence of gradient of H bar. So here you can apply the divergence of J bar plus divergence of N bar. This total is equation is equal to 0. Why? Because divergence of gradient of any vector is equal to 0. So at that time this total equation is equal to 0. So previously you can write, okay, divergence of J bar equal to minus d rho v by dt. Okay, so here divergence of J bar plus divergence of N bar is equal to 0. So this total term will becomes to 0. So here the divergence of J bar equal to minus d rho v by dt. So whenever you can take, okay, divergence of N bar equal to plus d rho v by dt, at that time this total value will becomes to 0. Okay, that's why here you can assume divergence of N bar equal to plus d rho v by dt. Okay, so according to the Gauss law, what is the statement of the Gauss law? Rho v equal to divergence of d bar. Okay, so in place of rho v, here you can apply divergence of d bar. So what happened? So in place of here rho v, you can apply the divergence of d bar. So at that time it will becomes divergence of n bar equal to divergence of dou d bar by dt. Okay, from this you can write n bar equal to dou d bar by dt. Okay, this value will be substituted here. Okay, in this equation, what happened? So the gradient of H bar equal to J bar plus N bar. So J bar here you can write the JC. Okay, in place of N bar you can get the dou D bar by dou D. okay na? So from this you can say that this is a displacement, the conduction current density. Here JC indicates the conduction current density, and d dou d bar by dt will be represents the displacement current density. So here you got a displacement current density and displacement current, okay na? So this is a conduction current and this is a displacement current density. Here dou d bar by dt will be indicates the displacement current density, okay na? This is the equation for a displacement current density and displacement current. Okay, here you can assume first one ampere circuitor law. Okay, gradient of h bar equal to j bar. From this you can apply the divergence, and from the equation of continuity as well as the Gauss law, finally you can apply the curl of h bar equal to jc plus dou d bar by dt. Okay, so here dou d bar by dt will be denoted with jd. Okay, at that time you can write jc plus jd. Conduction current density, displacement current density. Okay, this is the equation. Okay, this is also very, very important. Okay, displacement current density and displacement.